Fujifilm XE4 versus Lumix GX9. A newer APS-C Fujifilm camera with a very very good sensor versus an old Micro Four Thirds camera. What are my impressions about these two cameras? Hi there, my name is Tudor Matescu and on my channel I talk about photography gear tips and tricks. I'm a multi-system user. I use Fujifilm, Micro Four Thirds, Sony cameras, full frame cameras and so on. And I like to compare this kind of systems and this kind of cameras. And now I want to talk about Fujifilm XE4 versus Lumix GX9. How these cameras are stacking to each other and what is my opinion regarding these two cameras. And if you want to buy a camera and maybe you are on a budget, we should find out if Lumix GX9 is a camera suitable for you in these present times. So if you like this kind of content, please subscribe to my channel and let's get to the subject. The first key point that I want to address is regarding the ergonomics of these two cameras. Fujifilm cameras are known for good ergonomics, but few people are knowing that Lumix cameras have very very good ergonomics. And in my point of view, Lumix GX9 is one of the best camera out there relating to ergonomics. It has this EVF that it is flipping, beautiful design. I really like that. It is really helping you when it is very bright outside and you want to use the EVF, you can use it like this. Very very useful. It has this tilting screen and also very very important, the touch to shoot, the screen gestures of Lumix GX9 are working flawlessly. It's an amazing touch to shoot experience. The screen, it is superb from this point of view. On the other side, Fujifilm XE4 doesn't have such a good LCD screen so you can shoot with it. Yes, it has touch gesture, but the screen, it is laggish. It's not working properly. So, big difference. This is a camera that I have for 3 years and this camera for 1 year. And I must tell you, this camera, it is above X-Pro3, XE4, X100V regarding the touch to shoot and the ergonomics of these cameras. And not just about the screen. No, this camera can be used with just one hand. I can change all kinds of settings just with my thumb. It's amazing. It's really an amazing camera. It has the best ergonomics out there from my point of view. And I'm telling you, as a Fujifilm user, as a Sony user, and so on, it's the best ergonomics out there. So really love what Lumix is doing to the ergonomics. Another key point to address in this field of ergonomics is the EVF quality. Yes, the EVF of XE4, it's a beautiful EVF, very clear and bright. It's doing the job very, very well. On the other side, yes, the EVF of this camera, it's not good at all, but it's a workable EVF. You will not be thrilled at all with this EVF, but you can bypass it. It's doing his job okay. And another important fact that I want to address, it's regarding the IBIS. XE4 doesn't have IBIS, but GX9 has a okay IBIS, a very good IBIS, I could say, for a camera that is that small. And this IBIS, it's really helping you in street photography, in videography, and so on. So huge point regarding the ergonomics. So from my point of view, Lumix GX9 is winning the ergonomics battle because, believe me, it is a very, very powerful camera with good ergonomics. Let's talk now about image quality. This will be a short chapter. Regarding image quality, in my opinion, Lumix GX9 is staying very well when you have good light. And if you use good lenses. But again, being a Micro Four Thirds sensor and not the latest and greatest from GH6, it will surely be behind XE4. So XE4, it's winning the image quality game by far, but again, how much image quality do you need? So I can't say, well, I have full frame quality here. No. There are situations when this sensor shines and there are other situations where things are equally. So this is very important to be sure what kind of photography you are doing. If you are doing street photography, if you are doing landscape photography, then GX9 can be equaled with XE4. But if you are doing portrait photography, if you are doing indoor photography where you want better image quality because of the low light, then again, yes, XE4 will have better image quality. But again, it's very important to understand that this camera doesn't have bad image quality. The quality of this camera, it is very workable, and in good light outside in cloudy days, you will not have any problems. You'll have problems when the sun is going out. When the sun is going out, then you should use an f1.4 lens on this camera and also on this camera, because that f2.8, it will not be sufficient in low light. So regarding this form factor, they are equally regarding these two lenses. On my GX9, I have the 20mm f1.7, a 40mm field of view lens, and this is a 40mm field of view lens, the 27 Mark II lens from Fujifilm. And regarding these two lenses, I must tell you again that this pancake lens, a Micro Four Thirds pancake lens, it is doing a better job than this Fujifilm lens, because it has an f1.7 aperture, so you can shoot it by night, and also because it has a very good minimum focus distance. So this is a huge factor. And again, with the IBIS from Lumix, it is staying very well regarding this chapter. But again, regarding AF, yes, this is a little slower, but it will do the job okay. So regarding image quality, it really depends, I think, on the lenses and on what you are shooting. They are equally at image quality, just thinking at my style of shooting, and this style of shooting, it's referring to street photography, family pictures, nature pictures, and some low light photography. But again, when I want to go to a very low light night street photography scene, yes, XE4 will do a better job. Now the next point that I want to address is regarding the street photography game. How these cameras are performing in the street photography game. And this is a very important thing to address, because Lumix GX9, it's a street machine. Yes, it is a street machine, but also XE4 can be called like that. But from my point of view, regarding the street photography game, you can do good street photography with each camera. No problem at all regarding street photography. But again, the ergonomics of Lumix GX9 are making this camera a better arm for street photography. With this pancake lens, with the IBIS, you can do, in my opinion, more than you can do with XE4. And also, you can take videography, street videography, and shoot in the same time. I've made a video with this camera and Olympus 12-100C, links in the card, where I filmed the street photography POV with just this camera and with that zoom lens. And as you can see on that video, the results are amazing. So regarding street photography, in my opinion, Lumix GX9, it is on the same spot with X-Pro 3 and X100V. It is an amazing street photography camera. It really is, because of all the ergonomics, because of the perfect touch to shoot. You can get very close to the people and just press the screen with the thumb and you can take pictures, and they will not know that you have taken their pictures because you will not push the shutter button. So just touch and shoot, touch and shoot. And this screen and this AF, are working so well that you can obtain very good results while working. While working. So you work and shoot. Work and touch to shoot. Work and touch to shoot. This is an amazing future. Fujifilm XT4 can't do that, and also other Fujifilm cameras from what I'm knowing. So again, beautiful, beautiful street machine. From my point of view, it's the number one. I really love this camera for what it can offer in the street photography game. From the idea that it can offer a lot of variety of street photography styles. So this is why I love it. And it is, how I said, suitable for all these styles. And this screen, believe me, try it, see it for yourself, what it can do for your street photography. Touch to shoot, touch to shoot, walk and touch to shoot. Beautiful. Regarding video performance, well, I must tell you that I've tried to vlog with this camera in the studio, and because of the overheating, I wasn't able to do the vlog. It was terrible, terrible. I saw on the YouTube that some people were able to obtain some good vlogs with this camera, but maybe outside in cold weather it will do the job. But for me, I will not use this camera more than B-rolls, short movies and so on because of the overheating problem. This is the problem with this camera. It overheats very, very strong, and especially in the video field. So, regarding Lumix GX9, the videography, it is amazing videography. You can shoot 4K, IBIS, I really don't have any complaints. Lumix are known for their good videography and capable cameras, and this small camera, it is very suitable to shoot in the studio. My wife is shooting her YouTube painting videos with this camera, long videos. And what I can tell you, very performant camera outside, indoors, in the studio regarding videography. So, another point for Lumix GX9. Now, my overall impressions and conclusion. Well, what I can say you is that I really love Lumix GX9. It is a camera with soul. So this is why I consider this camera in the same field with X100V and X-Pro3. XT4, I like the camera. It is a very good camera, a very good digital camera, but it doesn't have that soul. And for me, that soul of the camera, it is important. It is helping me, it is motivating me to go outside, to take the cameras and shoot with them. So this factor is very important for me. Also, the ergonomics are very, very good on this camera. And from my point of view, GX9, it is a better camera than XE4 regarding all the factors that we've talked in this video. But again, XE4 has a better sensor, so you'll get better image quality from this XE4. But if you want this small package will not offer you such good image quality. It will be okay, it will be a little above this camera. But if you want better image quality, better use XE4 with the 35mm f1.4 lens or other good lenses from Fujifilm. So it's a hard decision, but again, yes, I understand why people are avoiding Micro Four Thirds. And what I hope now, it is that Lumix will take the newer sensor from GH6. From the results that we are seeing online, the sensor, it is great. It is very, very good in a low light. And if they will put that sensor in a small camera, a future GX10, then I don't know what discussion should we have at that moment. But what I can tell you from my real use experience is that I will sell XE4, but surely I will not sell GX9. I really love this camera, and I can't let go of this camera. It is an amazing camera. It is a camera that fulfill all my street photography needs. And in 2019, I was able to document an entire year of street photography with this camera. And I hope soon to be able to make a Zynor ebook with the photography that I've got from that year with this camera. And when I'm looking at those photos, they are very, very good photos. Here I have some photos from the 2019 printed from this camera, from Lumix GX9, edited with Nick Silver, and also with the Cobalt profiles. When you apply the Cobalt profiles on a Lumix GX9 camera, and this is very important to tell you, you'll get an amazing quality from Adobe Lightroom. So again, the software and all the editing programs that made some advances are able to recover and to get you there with an older Micro Four sensor. So this is why, again, for me, Lumix GX9, it's winning this battle. I really love this camera, and believe me, take it, try it. I think you can find it at a very good price nowadays. You will really enjoy it. I really do believe that you will really enjoy it. But yes, you must know to obtain and to edit the files. But you can do some good settings also on these cameras, on this Lumix camera. This Lumix camera has a tons of ergonomics and options, so you can customize the JPEGs like on a Fujifilm camera. So this was another important stuff to say. So thank you for watching. Maybe I will do a more in-depth review of the Lumix GX9 and what you can do with this camera, this old camera, at another time. So thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel for more content like this, and please be sure to check the links from the comments and from the description for a private POV where I shoot X100V with X-Pro3 and I document a turbulent event. Thank you for watching. Please tell me in the comments what you think if you used one of these cameras, and what are your opinions about Micro Four Thirds cameras in our present times. Thank you for watching, and talk to you soon. Bye bye. They don't think we can keep doing this. They don't think we can keep making hits about cameras. But I'm the cameraman. But I'm the cameraman. Stay creamy. Yeah, started on a 50 mil lens. Now I'm about to bag 50 mil yen. I can shoot all day, I got stamina. Turtleneck on with my camera, yeah. Stay creamy, man, that's what they say. Shoes laced up and I came to play. Yeah, I'm first team, I'm a superstar. They call me cream, like Abdul-Jabbar. Yeah, you had to face it, let's get back to basics. I'ma take the shot like it's a vaccination. I don't have the patience, I'ma shoot right now. Yeah, we undefeated and you gon' lose right now. Like click, 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 swish. I can switch it up anytime like this. I'm a videographer and I'm on the verse. So when I shoot my shot, I don't miss. I'm gon' take the shot. Take the shot.